to this. There's plenty going on. The race village is bustling. The sun is still out.
I really hope to help represent Chris in one of two entries in this Transat.
Just to tell you that long time ago, there were the English sailors were the best on the sea. But a little froggy decided that maybe he can be the best too.
Attendu, ouais, bah c'est pas anodin, hein. Ça reste, c'est quand même une putain de course, hein. Tu pars, c'est l'hiver, t'arrives, c'est l'hiver, t'as quand même pas mal de trucs en travers.
Ça va ?
C'est juste super excitant, il y a forcément une pression parce que c'est pas rien. Naviguer sur des bateaux comme ça tout seul, c'est la première fois que j'ai traversé l'Atlantique sur le trimaran massif, donc. Il y a de l'émotion, mais c'est des belles émotions.
Oh, it means a very tough, grueling race across all the way across the Atlantic and all the way to New York. I think it's going to be very, very hard, literally from the beginning to end. And I think we can expect anything out there.
We had a really bad story this winter, and hopefully we are here. And so we spent a lot of time to rebuild and refit the boat. And so for the team and me, we are little tired because it was hard, and we don't have a lot of sail. But it's like a victory to be here, so it will be good to be on the other side and to cross the Atlantic.
We'll be right back.
Antigua Sailing Week.
Antigua.
California.
England.
Lithuania.
Wisconsin, USA.
Curacao.
Argentina.
On day three, the breeze settled in at around 12 knots, and all fleets enjoyed two super close races. Reporter Louay Habib tracks the stories as they unfold.
The standout performers have got to be the three boats that are unbeaten. That's Gladiator, Gypsy Hugo and Ella Carso.
Yeah, look, we're really, really happy. We've got a hot boat from Miami. We've got sailing with our family and friends. It's going really well. There's three more races to go, in fact, so you know, we have to keep our fingers crossed.
Of the 100 boats competing at this year's Antigua Sailing Week, one of the coolest is Kealoha 3. This 78-foot beauty was unbeatable on the maxi circuit in the mid-70s, and in 75 she set a Sydney Hobart record that stood for 21 years. Roland Pieper is a co-owner and helmsman.
I think Kealoha 3 was one of the very first maxis. You know, in 1974, you know, we are still going across the track and we can fight with anybody. So, you know, for a boat that old, to be competing at the top level is remarkable.
Roland sails with a mix of Spanish and Dutch friends, with Roy Heiner calling tactics.
So, difficult day today, more wind, so the little boats have a big advantage. So we'll just see how it pans out, see how far we're ahead at the halfway mark.
Kealoha 3 won Antigua Sailing Week in 1979. She was a thoroughbred then, now she's a modern classic. With one more race to go, tension is mounting in all 11 fleets.
3 days of great racing at the 49th annual Antigua Sailing Week have led to Lay Day. The day about fun, enjoyment, great racing out on the beach with pro sailors.
Eight teams competed off the beach for a holiday at Nonsuch Bay Resort. Nice prize for the victors from Itchener Sailing Club.
I've set up my chair right here to be a part of all of this because the beach volleys are absolutely amazing.
Marvelous.
Fantastic.
Bigissimo.
Awesome.
It is amazing.
Super fun. Two words, hyphenated.
It's all about enjoying it, and that's what we're doing right here at Pigeon Beach.
And this year, reggae star Luciano held center stage. More race days to go, stand by for the finale. The 49th edition of Antigua Sailing Week has delivered across the board. All 11 classes have enjoyed close racing on the two course areas off the south of this gorgeous island. We've enjoyed seeing the faster boats like Gladiator, Tonnerre and Kealoha 3 flying around the track. And the bareboat classes are always well matched for close quarters combat. The Brits on El Ocaso were looking good for overall glory, but with the fantastic parties midweek, well, let's just say their eyes were temporarily distracted from the ball. The top performers came from Class 7 aboard Gypsy Hugo. Congratulations to Sir Hugh Bailey and crew.
We want to win next year, the 50th year. I was there from the very first one, and I'm the only captain left on the race course today.
Next year's 50th anniversary of this dream regatta will be extra special.
It's going to be a festival and celebration of 50 years of yacht racing in Antigua. It is the culmination of the Caribbean yachting season for everybody. So whatever your boat, head here, be part of the celebrations. And once you're done, we can get you to wherever you need to go, because Peters and May will be shipping out from here to all the destinations that you need to get to for racing.
Sounds like a once-in-a-lifetime occasion not to miss.
The event went really well for me. I led from start to finish, which is always hard to do, but you know, I started the event with a win on day one, and managed to stay on top of the board for the rest of the week, and it was good. We had a mix of conditions, you know, we had light air and heavy air, and I think it was a good test of an all-round sailor this week. It feels awesome. I mean, this September in Rio is what I've been working for the last 4 years, ever since London, and you know, to come out and start my European season with a win, I feel absolutely stoked, and you know, hopefully it'll give me confidence moving into the next major regatta, which is the Worlds, and then inevitably the really important one, which is the Paralympic Games this September.
Oh, it's a great way to finish the regatta with a result that put us just off the podium this time. We're fourth overall, which is a bit of a reality check, as since London we haven't been off the podium, so it's kind of good opportunity to look at the little things that maybe we need to just tidy up a bit. Tough day on the water today with quite shifty breeze, but very close racing in our fleet as always. So from here we head off to Garda to continue our European tour, and then from Garda on to Medemblik, where we've got our world. So a couple of more events in Europe before going over to Rio for a test event, and then finally the Games in September.
Welcome! 2016 Open BIC North Americans! Yeah. We call this an Un-Regatta for a reason, because we're a little bit unlike other regattas.
They're all
What is he doing? Boom, 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 boom.
Founded in 1979 by the BIC family of BIC Pen fame, BIC Sport grew from the family's passion for water sports and expertise in sustainable manufacturing. Visit BICSport.com to learn more and discover the full range of BIC Sport products.
A peerless competition in a city like no other. The America's Cup in New York City. It's the return after 100 years of the world's oldest and most important yachting regatta to the metropolis on the Hudson River. The Oracle Team USA knows the significance of the race.
It'll be an experience that I don't think we'll ever forget.
It's going to be amazing racing on the Hudson River. A lot of spectators.
The title defenders, led by skipper Jimmy Spittle, have trained, fought and suffered for one goal.
Some of the decisions that we will make over this summer will ultimately decide whether or not we'll win the America's Cup.
Six teams from all over the world face each other. The outcome, uncertain.
But it'll be tough. I mean, all of the teams now, they are at such a high level that anyone really can win.
Top speed on the water, overlooked by the new World Trade Center and the Statue of Liberty.
And I don't think you get a better stadium for a sporting competition.
With technical support from BMW, the Oracle Team USA are going all out for victory. They want to show Team New Zealand, currently leading on points, who's the boss here.
I think it's an experience that very few people in the world will get the opportunity to do a race like that.
Hopefully we get really great wind and we'll put on a show for all the New York crowd.
On the weekend of the 7th and 8th of May, New York City, showdown in the Louis Vuitton America's Cup World Series.
Welcome to the 2016 Extreme Sailing Series from Qingdao, China. Eight world-class international teams now racing on cutting-edge hydrofoiling GC32s. After winning Act 1 on home waters, 2014 Series champion Morgan Larsen and Oman Air are the team to beat. The series has travelled over 6,000 kilometres to China's sailing city, Qingdao. Wind conditions over the past few days have been light and patchy, which has changed the race course into a game of snakes and ladders. It's Alingi who lead the way in China, chasing hard. It's Oman Air and Sail Portugal, followed by three teams tied in fourth. It's still all to play for. It's the final day of racing in Qingdao, China. 15 seconds to go, and we might have seen Team Turks just find a beautiful leeward position. The fleet starting to bear away, and the Code Zeros coming out. Red Bull Extreme Sailing Team being closed out at the committee boat end.
So that's a good start down midline. There's an individual recall there, so there'll be a slowdown penalty. Who is it, Niall?
It's Oman Air that's been called over the line at the moment. They were really aggressive down at that leeward end, trying to get their bows clear over Team Turks, and it hasn't gone their way. They're going to have to slow down, let the fleet go over the top of them. A lingy now on the windward side, just going out the right-hand side of your picture, sailing nicely. Sail Portugal struggling to get that Code Zero trimmed on and pulling. We've seen this earlier today. A lot of the crews, that wind changes and they're struggling to change gear.
We've got a lead change with a lingy rolling over the top of SAP as they just now dump down off the foils, but it's all about dragging that apparent wind forward and then getting on the foils. And once you're on the foils, the speed will shoot up, and it's a lingy in the lead.
Well, this couldn't go any better for Arnoud Serafagis, the skipper of Alinghi. They have positioned themselves right to the front with their rival Oman Air and Morgan Larsen languishing at the back at the first mark. This is a major battle here, and Alinghi are going to be doing a lot of watching behind them. Can they keep Morgan Larsen at the back of the pack? Surely this race could just sew up their victory. Land Rover BAR chasing them hard. They are feeling confident about being over this ley line. The Code Zeros comes out. So halfway up this beat, the conditions changing so much. We've also got SAP Extreme coming in, but now we can see Alinghi round the top of the course. They made that ley line work for them, that last puff giving them the height they needed.
Yeah, they went all the way to the ley line and then to the Simo tack, and Alinghi were able to just press a little harder and take that speed advantage so that they could sneak through the wind shadow right here at that top mark.
Well, the Swiss team Alinghi, skippered by Arnoud Serafagis, across the line, and just behind them we can see Oman Air languishing in fifth place. They've done well to come back from last. Still, that's not good enough. Land Rover BAR crossed the finish line up on the foils. Much better performance from Lee McMillan and his young academy team.
Certainly is then.
Well, Alinghi holding on to the top spot. They looked set to finish high in this regatta, had a good fight with Oman Air in those last few races, but they've secured the number one spot. Red Bull Sailing Team taking that third spot, holding off Land Rover BAR Academy. Now, a very interesting race here in Qingdao. Alinghi had to work hard for that victory.